Okay, welcome back to my Let's Play of Legend of Zelda Phantom Hourglass on the DS. Yeah, you use a stylus to do stuff. What more do I need to say? Also, we have to use the microphone or a pretend microphone in order to blow out these candles. I think I solved that issue. Yep, there we go. There we go. Sound should be appropriately loud now. And I'm not sure if I fixed the kind of weird little glitchy issue. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I didn't really check it. That is so hot. Oh no, there are flames everywhere. You better not touch them. Don't go and burn yourself, Mangg. Great. So I was looking at what people were saying about Phantom Hourglass, like review-wise and stuff. And people were like, the reviewers were like, well, you know, it's a great Zelda, but it's more for the casual fans of the series. It's like, well, shit. And nobody wanted to hear that. Oh, I can draw the path out on my map. Look at this. We'll draw. Oh, we're drawing. Uh-huh. Guess I would not be able to remember that. There we go. That's my drawing. Okay. I wonder what that means, but let's make note of it. Go ahead, copy that path by writing it on your map in case we need it later. Yeah, it's a casual Zelda. That's just what I want. That's just what I want. I mean, well, look at it. I start with the dungeon map. You don't get much more casual than that. So we're just going to be pretty much going through the motions, I guess. You don't even need... Yeah. Alright, here we go. There you go. I mean, I don't know how indicative this place is of the difficulty of the game, because it is the first dungeon. But I'm telling you, I think all the difficulty is gonna come from the controls. Which is not what you want to hear. You're gonna get potted. Boom! Oh no, little blobs that I have to click on. Holy shit, the difficulty. It's off the charts, folks! Got the boomerang. This item follows the path you draw on the screen. Boomerang, know how to throw it? First tap the item icon to equip the boomerang. Then just draw a line, you'll follow that path. Fly path, straight or curvy. Give it a try, throw it around this room to get the hang of it. Okay. That's kind of cool. Okay. Nice. Okay, don't tread on me. Damn it. Damn it. Hold on. Shit. There. Okay. What are you doing? I'm gonna scribble all over you. Okay. Click. Click. Yeah, I get it. I get it. I get it. Nice. Goes through walls. Click. Dead. Okay, well, that's our shortcut back to the start. Oh no! Click, 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 kill, click, click, dead. Yeah. See, I feel like this one, more than any other Zelda, this is one where I'd like to have somebody play it for me, and I could just do commentary. Hold up. Damn it. He is unbeatable. There's no locking on with it, I guess. That's really annoying. But we can scribble around a bunch. We'll get him. You're not escaping that shit. That's pretty cool. Nice. Yeah, well, we'll see if money is worth it. It's hit or miss every game. I'm never sure. Usually, it's not necessary. But Wind Waker really threw me for a loop. And this is a sequel to Wind Waker. Would you stop? Shit, I don't have a key, do I? No. No, I don't. Oh, I thought you could go through walls. What the hell happened? Huh. Oh, right. But of course. You... what? Do things... yeah, okay. I'll go stand over here. And I'll beat the ever-loving shit out of you, boy! Damn it! Come on. Oh, come on. All Bullshit. Is it on a timer or... There you go, get wrecked. Yeah, obviously I'm not using a walkthrough for this dungeon. Yeah. Now I don't know how casual Spirit Tracks is gonna be. Quick as you can, flip the four switches in order. Okay. I can handle that. Yeah, I think I'll remember it. Shit. This pot was not worth it at all. But I'm pretty sure Skyward Sword is not that casual. Okay, great. Well, you can blow out the, blow out your candles. Okay, so one, two, three, may have messed up the order, but something like that. Nice. Nice. Hey. Whoa, what's this? It looks so ominous. Yeah, that's called the boss door. First, we have to kill some little things, though. Oh, hold on. It's gonna be annoying. Hold on. Oh, I actually got him. Holy shit. Alright. Nice. Draw lines. Okay. Just scribble something down. You'll get him. It shows you, you know, on the map exactly where, like, an event just happened and stuff. That's kind of handy. It's very casual. That's not necessarily a bad thing, to be casual. It's not necessarily what I'm looking for. Especially in a 2D Zelda, because 2D Zeldas are like... supposed to be my bastion of Zelda goodness between the 3D ones. Oh, my bad. I thought you would actually, you know, jump. Yeah, let's get the boss key. Alright. Oh, I actually have to carry it. Oh, man. Well, that's not casual. It's not casual at all. Alright. So we got to the boss in under 15 minutes. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. But now, here's the moment we've been waiting for. The cookie clicker boss. I can feel an evil presence lingering at the top of these stairs. Be careful, okay, Mangg? Sure thing, boy. Boil. What could possibly go wrong? We're gonna have to scribble real furiously. Blaz, Master of Fire. Damn. Get him, get him, get him. Damn it. Maybe I'm supposed to hit him with the boomerang again after that? I don't know. It's very quick. Something doesn't feel right. Look at me, I'm rolling. Okay, they didn't shoot anything. Odd. There we go. Nice. Hey, 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 hey! Yeah, the spin attack is really difficult to pull off. And even that doesn't really work. So maybe I'm supposed to just do this a bunch. Yeah, I think I'm just supposed to do it a bunch. Okay. Shit. I'm gonna heal. I don't want to die. Okay. That's odd. It, like, doesn't want me to chain it real quick. Right after they get grabbed. And sometimes doesn't want me to chain it together at all. I mean, I thought it was just you have to do this a bunch of times. Maybe. I don't know. Get stunned. Yeah. Well, there you have it. Boss battle. Now, if you were paying attention, I don't know. I don't know how well people really pay attention to my videos. But if you were paying attention, you may have noticed that the boss didn't actually do a single attack. From what I understood, it seemed like they were preparing an attack, but they never actually commenced it. Now, maybe I'm just really good and really quick, but yeah, they didn't do anything. Oh, apparently he was supposed to start summoning large boulders of fire that fall from the ceiling. But no. And apparently you were supposed to target the little guys in like a sequential order. Maybe that's what I was doing. Like, occasionally I got it right. But okay. I am Leaf, Spirit of Power. I serve the Ocean King. I owe you thanks for defeating that evil wizard. You broke the seal, so now I'm free. Look, Mangg. It's the Spirit of Power, Leap. He just freaking introduced himself, you shit. This must all be what Astrid was talking about. Oh my gosh. Like, if some guy introduces himself to you, and then your buddy's like, hey, look, it's... you know, the manager of the Applebee's. It's like, what are you, retarded? Please help us, we need your strength. I was locked away with the Ocean King years ago, but now I can't feel the Ocean King's presence. I wonder what happened to him. If I come with you, maybe I can find out. If you need it, I will gladly lend a hand. Great, I'm gonna have like a whole flock of fairies with me. Spirit of Power Leaf has joined your group. You should go tell Astrid. Well, that was a 20-minute dungeon. The volcano has stopped erupting, Mangg. I'll bet it's because you defeated all the monsters, Mangg. Quit saying my name. You'll wear it out. Come on, let's tell Astrid. Yeah, let's do so. Hey, kid, so you were able to defeat all the monsters while Astrid is waiting? Well done, you defeated the power of darkness, Mangg. Thus, you've broken the seal that imprisoned the spirit you need to move ahead. Ultimately, you will need three spirits, power, wisdom, and courage. When you have all three, you will possess the power to find the ghost ship. Now two spirits remain, but their locations are veiled to me at present. I see, another clue for you to find in the Temple of the Ocean King on Merkay. To further your efforts, I give you this. May it help you in battle. Oh, you got a power gem. It radiates power, but you can't use it like this. Store it on the collection screen for now. That's a spirit gem. There are many for each spirit. Find as many as you can. I see that somewhere in the seas, you can raise a spirit's power for 10 gems. The light that seeks your aid grows weaker still. There's no time to lose. You actually did it. Now we're even closer to getting rich, Mangg. Hoo-haw, I'm excited. Ugh, he's so self-centered. Well, I sense that man will prove to be an asset and not an anchor in time. I hope you're right. Okay, let's quickly set sail back to Merkay Island, Mangg. Let's go. It's taking so long. I was about to leave you here, Mangg. What, Lineback? What are you going on about? I suspect that we're hot on the trail of untold wealth. Don't you suspect that the light that needs finding is really a shiny treasure? I really don't think so. Anyway, let's head back to Merkay Island. Yes. Haven't forgotten anything, have you? Okay, let's be off. Let's go. Alright. Go as straight a route as I can manage. Okay, so it seems like we're gonna have to continually return to the Temple of the Ocean King throughout the game as we continue to explore it. I mean, I guess I would have a really big problem with that if I had to actually drive the ship, but since I can just sit here and go on Facebook or something, then whatever. Okay, let's go. I guess we can roll. We can roll. It's not too big of a deal. It's not quite as enjoyable as rolling in other games. Because I'm rolling with a mouse. Oh, I probably should have picked that up, but sure. Mm. Hey, wait, wait. If you push yourself that hard from the beginning, you won't last. I understand wanting to hurry, but don't waste your energy. Don't forget that this cursed temple can suck the life out of you. I know we have to search for clues to find the spirits, but we need some kind of strategy. Just don't end up like this. Hey, you know, I mean, if you say you want to go it alone, then who am I to stop you? What? You trying to put all the work on Mangg again? I'm used to it, really. If you know it's dangerous, shouldn't you be helping too? Well, yeah, kid. The temple is a little dangerous. Not a place for, kids. If you go in, well, you might not make it very far. That's not exactly true.
What?
Grandpa! I'm impressed you managed to free the spirit of power. You are strong. Even if you follow the ghost ship, you will be fine. Mangg. Get up on that altar. Okay. Yes, sir. Oh. Oh, right. The big altar. I got you. Hold on. Let me just destroy this shit first. It's priceless artifacts. Ooh, the Phantom Hourglass. There it is. Now, Mangg, take the hourglass. Yoink. You got the Phantom Hourglass. It's a mysterious hourglass filled with golden sand. Now here's a lengthy bit of dialogue to explain it.
You now hold the legendary Phantom Hourglass, Mangg. As long as you carry it, this temple cannot drain the life from you.
Woohoo! As long as we have this, we can search for clues for the spirit.
However, you are only safe as long as sand remains in the top of the Phantom Hourglass. When all the sand is drained to the bottom, your life too will be drained. But then we can just flip it over. Right?
Ah! Ha ha ha! It's an hourglass. Can't you just flip it over again?
No. Once the sand of hours is drained, its power is lost. It needs the light of the sun to restore its mystical power.
Ah, I get it. So we have to go outside the temple again.
The sand inside the Phantom Hourglass is called the Sand of Hours. The beast you defeated in the Temple of Fire held some grains of it. It is said to be made of Force Gems.
Force Gems!
Of the Great Spirit, the Ocean King. It gives deep strength to whoever holds its power. From now on, you must defeat monsters and collect their Sand of Hours. For the more sand you place in the hourglass, the longer its power will last. The sea chart we found in this temple showed where to find the captured spirit. If that's the case, then the location of the other two spirits... Bet there's another clue hidden somewhere in this temple. I just know it. I won't stop you, Mangg. Dive deeper into this mystery, but keep the Phantom Hourglass in hand. Remember how Astrid was saying that the sacred light was fading? Gotta hurry, Mangg. So how do you know so much, old man? That long story is not yet ready to surface, but all will come in time. For now, you must find the ghost ship. That's right. A mountain of treasure awaits, ready to leap into my pockets. Hop to it, Mangg. Put some steam in your engines and get exploring this temple, kid.
Sure thing. If you guys would talk less, I would do it even faster. Never any hearts. So we have 10 minutes. And it only drains when we're step off of the... Yeah, I get it. Yeah, I got it. It only drains... this is door of power. Use my strength to open it. Tap the door and let's go even deeper into the temple. It only drains when we're off the thing, and then when it's depleted, you know, we can still keep going. It's just we start getting drained. I think we'll be okay. Ho ho. Hey, it's an enemy. You know what to do. Wait, Mangg. The evil accursed temple made these monsters. Phantoms are very dangerous enemies. Their armor is nearly impenetrable, and they strike very hard. Does that mean you can't defeat them? There has to be a way. Well, all you can do is sneak by the phantoms so they don't see you. You can watch their movements on your map. This is where the phantoms are. The cone shows where they are looking. So we have to sneak around like thieves, eh? What if we're seen? If they see you, run straight for a safe zone. By safe zone, do you mean those purple spaces on the ground? Oh yeah, the sand stopped moving in the hourglass when we were in one. That's right, those purple tiles on the floor are safe zones. This temple's curse makes it a dangerous place, but it's not all bad. Those safe zones remain as places that evil can't get to. Okay, so if phantom spots, you just run to a safe zone, that's easy. Right, Mangg? Yes. Yeah, alright. I think. Yeah. Good. Okay. I think it's just kind of a waiting game. Shit. Uh-oh. Give me that key. Give me that key. Got the small key. So now I guess we have to go all the way around in order to get to the door in the upper right. Well, that's just shit. Yeah, that's what we have to do. Mandatory stealth. Nothing like it in the world. Yep. Good old Zelda. Can I make it? Can I make it? Can I make it? Probably, yes. No problem. Good. Good. We only used up a minute of our time. Okay, thank you. Oh shit, I see. Oh, he'll get me. Oh, I didn't want to run up. Wow, he turned around really quick. Oh, I got it this time. Eat shit, man. You ain't getting nobody. good. Alright. Oh, those create safe spots. That's interesting. That's kind of handy. Boomerang, probably. That's easier. Oh, can you do it? You can do it. What did that do? Maybe I have to hit both of them. Well, let's see what we can do, shall we? There we go. Oh, I don't know about that one. Probably not. Maybe. Nope. So we gotta be... Well... There. Gives us a key, but that does not lower this. I think we just want to hit this with the boomerang. Et voila. That ain't really doing much for me. The spikes, huh? Well, I imagine the spikes are controlled by that. Wow. It's real casual, Zelda. If you don't know about patrols, you ain't been on this earth for too long. That's dangerous. Shit. Chase me, bitch. Well, he patrolled. Does he step on it? And it seems like it would be outside of his patrol. So that's... Oh, shit. Boomerang. Real quick now. Hey, see ya, buddy. Yeah, I notice this is cracked, but doesn't seem like you can do much about it. Alrighty. Hopefully there isn't too much more, because this isn't even really a dungeon. Oh, another floor. Clue to the ghost ship rests on this floor, just a little farther. Don't say. We found a force gem. Take it away quietly. Got a triangle. I wonder what you're supposed to do with it. That is a force gem stolen from the Ocean King by the hands of evil. You need the power of force gems to open a door and delve deeper. So what are you supposed to do with this force gem? I can see it over there. There are the pedestals where the force gems go. Place all force gems here and the door will open. Oh, so all you have to do is take the force gems there. Be careful, you move a lot slower when you're carrying a big force gem. If Phantom sees you and you don't think you can get away, don't be a hero, drop the force gem and run to a safe zone. Simple, right, Mangg? Look out for the phantoms and lug those you have nibbled out. No problem. Five minutes and 50 seconds. That phantom is carrying a key. Probably have to boomerang it off of him. Does he turn? No, he does not turn. Okay. Shit. No. Hold up. Got a boomerang this way. Hell did that do? I guess that must have just turned him off. Alright, let's keep running around. I need the key to get in there. There's a lever here. That's good. The key is probably the last thing I'm gonna try to get. Okay, or not. See ya. Yeah, okay, fine. Well, I think we've kind of figured everything out. Nice. Pick it up. Alright, I don't think the time limit is a huge problem. Yet. Could become a big pain in the ass. Basically as lengthy as a dungeon. Let's wrap it up. Huh, wait, there's no fog in this room. Look. Hourglass has stopped and your life force isn't being drained. This place isn't cursed yet. I think we can finally relax. Great. Oh, you can pick up more time. Well, I wouldn't want to do that. There's a big chest here. Tonight's sea chart, northwestern sea chart. That's the whole world, is these four sections. That is pretty short. Now you can explore a new area of the sea. Got another sea chart, but it looks different from the last one. Well, I would hope so. Maybe now we can explore new areas of the sea. Let's show line back. Let's show line back. I mean, so far the game isn't really terrible. It's just really easy. Hey, you actually made it back. Find the sea chart? Mindbeck, you're lucky to have us around doing all the hard work. Yes, we found the new sea chart. Hey, let me see that. It's a chart we need to sail into the sea that's up north. We still don't know the location of the ghost ship. Well, blow me down to the ground. The chart's so dusty I can't read it. Make yourself useful and clean it up, will you, Mangg? Oh, sure, here you go, buddy. Get blown. Well, this is not the most effective. It It's like little baby puffs. I need a big gust of wind here, man. Hold on, let me just change. No, that didn't do anything. Okay. Then we have to do that little baby puffs. And you can't mash the button either. You have to hold it down for like a second. We'll get there. This guy's just watching me as I'm just... I'm almost there, man. I almost got it. It was a lot of work. I could have just like shaken it out. Oh, hey, another crest has appeared. Achoo. Hey, look. I mean, I knew it was all along. I knew it was hidden there. I've always had a sixth sense for such things. We aren't falling for it, Lineback. You didn't know that was there. Don't pretend to know what I don't know. Anyway, I bet a spirit's right there. So let's go to that island. Okay, then. Once we set sail, explain how we can go to the Northwestern Sea. Let's be off, yes. Climb aboard the open sea call. Okay. Now we have a new sea chart. Let's set a course north and explore. Tell you what I know about how to navigate our way up there. Sea chart of the Northwestern Sea covers a whole area north of here. So draw a course to the top of our chart until you see Northwestern Sea. After we reach it, you must draw our next leg on the Northwestern Sea chart. Neat, huh? Right? Yeah. Yeah. Let's go! And we're off. So, we actually apparently can't just go north. We have to go do a whole side excursion. That sucks. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. Ah, what was that? Madness, I tell you. Well, it looks like we can't head up north that way, at least for the time being. Better try another route. What a pain. Yeah, great. So, we actually want to go here. Cannon Island. Hey, see that weird thing that just surfaced, Mangg? It's called a sea trap, and we're headed right for it. Can't attack it, so we have only one option. Make the ship jump over it. Tap the jump arrow at the screen's bottom to jump, but only at the right time. Okay. So now I actually have to watch for that, instead of just going on Facebook. Well, I probably should have found out what happens if I run into it. Hey, nice to meet you. Not like I don't want to greet you, but I'm here to deliver your mail. Not talk your ear off. Yep, the postman lives for special delivery. And your name is... Got it right here. Isn't it Mangg? I'm sure I'll be carrying special deliveries for you at some point. So I'd appreciate it if you didn't, you know, shoot me with a slingshot. Thanks for understanding. I may also need you to sign for deliveries. Thanks. On that note, see you around the sea, sir. Okay, and why do you have wings? I don't know. Hello there, you've come to Edo's garage, that is Master Edo's shop. I'm Fuzo, his apprentice. And you, oh, nice to meet you, Mangg. What, you want a cannon? Sorry, little guy, but we don't have any ready to sell. Not yet. Master's working on one, though, so he's withdrawn to his workroom. Yep, he's gone and locked himself in there until he's done concentrating. If you really, really, really want a cannon, then go speak with the master. Go around the island to reach the back door. Dangerous, though. Back door's never locked, so that's your ticket to meet the master. I'd be happy to open the gate that leads to the rest of the island. Follow me. You know, I could literally just, like, sail around, or I'm sure I could hop this fence and... Damn it. So yeah, we just have to navigate. We got a treasure map. That's not what I care about. Oh, the bees! Not the bees! Oh, ooh. So I didn't even mean to do that. Okay, we got bomb flowers now that we can use. Like so. Can't really pull it either direction. I might be able to throw a bomb over, maybe. Okay, let's try throwing a bomb. Boom. Bada bing, bada boom. Oh shit. Oh shit. No, get over there. All right. Here's your bomb. Choke on it. How dare you? I think it is very casual so far. And I guess in a way it's sort of relaxing. You only need one hand. Not that I'm implying anything, I'm just saying it's a fact. You only need one hand. Oh, shit. And you definitely do not want to fall down at this point. I'm supposed to carry a bomb all that way? No, I'm supposed to throw it over the fence. I would think, but even that seems like a long way. Oh, I can drop down. Oh, shit. Shit. I'm just messing up all over the place. I'm only using one hand. That seems really quick, man. Give me some hearts or something. I'm gonna die. That seems like the fastest way. I just have to... Ah, fudge. I just have to be faster. Ugh! The cookie clicking! No. Nice! Good, good, good. Cut. Okay. Alright. Yes, yes, I'm the owner of this shop. Edo, what do you want? What? You demand a cannon? You impress me. You'd brave this dangerous isle for one of my cannons. For a sea shrimp, you've got a good eye. Then know that my cannons are works of explosive art, crafted from choice parts. So you'd better believe that you're going to cough up big rupees for one. Have the guts to hear how much? Yes. And yeah, don't blame me if you drop a load of rupees in my shop. Ready? I'll say it. Get ready, guy. I'm serious. I'm going to say it. It's going for the steep price of 50 rupees. Big enough to pony up 50 old rupees? Stunned, yeah? Did you think you were dealing with small potatoes here? Ha! I mean, 50 rupees would buy you a whole lot of good life on this isle. No one could blame you if you can't pay, but I found 50 rupees on the island. Like, what are you talking about? Got the cannon. This part from Edo fits on the deck of your ship. Next, I'm going to devise a salvage arm that can pull treasure from the seafloor. See you later, shrimp. Just see that door there to get back to the dock. Well, there you go. I needed money for stuff. Special delivery. Watch out, incoming. Why, what is it? Let me look this up. Oh, it's just an introduction letter. I don't even have the option of refusing it. Yeah. Be nice to the postman, that's what it says. Okay, I see. Right here. Hold on. Yeah. All right, let's go. Yes, I want to set sail. So, basically, we want to sail on the left side over there. And so you think, okay, just go through here and then you go north. But as soon as we get to that line of rocks, there actually is apparently some rocks that are blocking us. And so we do need the cannon to get past them. And in fact, I could have skipped going north the first time. Oh well. Okay, so that took away one of my hearts. But, I mean, it depends on how often they pop up on whether or not I care. I am asleep at the wheel. Get dead. You'd think that would have been represented on my map, but apparently not. I don't know why I drew such a wide arc on the way up north. Hang on a moment, Mangg. Look. Could that be... Uh-huh. It has surfaced at last. The ghost ship! I can't believe that we're laying eyes on it. Let's follow it. Let's go get our treasure. Yeah, go. Go, man. Get dead. What a weird way of just controlling your game. I have to click on the edges to control the camera. 20 rupees that thing dropped. fog is thickening. Be careful now, Mangg. This fog is maddening. I can't even see my hand in front of my face. He'll do fine. We're on a route. We can't be screwed. Okay. So literally we're just following the ship. So we'll just set a temporary route. Scuttle what thing? The ship? I'll shoot at the ship if you want. Ow. Okay. I assume it's just gonna go all the way north, but it... ₹20 more. I don't know what's blasting me. Hold on. Maybe the ghost ship is blasting me? Or maybe I was running over barrels? Yeah. God damn it. I ran right into it. And thus ends the legend of Mangg. Three game over so far. Shit. This sucks. Not in my face, seagull. Blast him! Blast him! Well, I guess I lied. Even with having the route, it is not... It's not perfect. It is still kind of tedious. Get out of my face, seagull. I mean, you get wealthy this way, I guess. Yeah, I know about the fog. Oh, it's annoying. Alright, so we'll just draw a path straight up through the north. Do that. I don't know if I have to follow the ghost ship. Exactly, but we will. And that's basically what we want to watch out for. Nice. Money. Nice money. Well, I mean, I guess I'm following the ship, right? technically that's not where we're going in the end, but... What? The fog, this is ridiculous. Oh, great. What? What happened? We were chugging along, making headway there. Ah, you think maybe... Could it be the influence of the ghost ship? What did I hear about that? Oh yeah, it's always surrounded by infernal fog. That fog leads ships horribly astray. I think it's best if we beat a hasty retreat, Mangg. Maybe someone on one of the nearby islands knows a way through this fog. What does that mean? Yep, shit, we actually have to go back. Damn, that's a lot of effort just to get to the second island. Shit. Okay. Dead. Dead. Oof, you got me. Nice shot. Why'd you have to shoot me like that? See you around the pond. Okay. Whatever that means. We can't navigate through the fog, so what are we supposed to do? We can't get to the crest location on the chart unless we pass through the fog. What do we do? Do you want to ship out? No. Then go take care of things and let's ship out soon. Okay. Bunch of crap we gotta do here. Eat something, kid? What, you want to travel to the Isle of Gust? Please don't tell me you're going your own way, too. Go your own way. Yes. Oh, really? Do it your own way. Do it your way. Go your own way. What a bunch of garbage. All this endless babbling about living with a lust for adventure. Yeah, can that put food on the table? Can that make your family happy? Going your own way is no way to survive in this life. My way's a lot better. Staying home, eating cheese. That's the life. Yeah, Isle of Gust, don't say another word about it. Figure it out yourself and get out of here. Okay. Wait, kid, come back. Nope, fuck you. You're an asshole, I hate you. Alright. Sorry to unload all that on you, kid. It's just that my dad used to say lots about going his own way to explore, and I got fed up with him. My dad used to talk about getting through to the fog and seeing the Isle of Gust. He said something about a specific route for getting through the foggy passage, but only he knew which way to go. It's a cave behind our house where my dad used to escape all the time. He called it his hideaway. You might find more details in there. But it's dangerous in there, so take care of yourself, kid. Yeah, I'll be the judge of that. Young man, you mustn't go into that cave. Dangerous monsters have been seen there lately. Be a good boy. Don't go anywhere near it. Oh, what? Well, if my son has said it's alright, go on in. There's no stopping you, is there? Please don't do anything too dangerous. Go fuck yourself. I don't get a map for this area. Oh boy. Must be that guy's dad. Ooh. Oh. Does he ever use his sword? Now he just spits fireballs. Okay. Oh, now he uses his sword. The controls are not meant for this, man. Okay, here. Eat boomerang. Nice. Done. Y'all got any of them hearts? No? Nice. Nice, 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 nice! Bomb flower, huh? And do I want to go in this crack? It's the shovel. It says there's a bunch of secret stuff you can dig up on the island. And I certainly believe that. What I'm not sure about... Well, okay. My journal. Writing this will in a private space I call my hideaway. Whenever I'm here, I find myself utterly at peace. And it will stay that way only as long as I know that no one will interrupt me. Now, I do have one more hideaway, and no one will ever find the entrance. It's under the spot where the lines drawn between my stone talents intersect. It's brilliant, if I do say so myself. How did you manage to, like, cave in your hideaway? It's impressive. Okay, I can get more money, basically. Okay, so... Uh-huh. There's multiple stone tablets. Alright, so we can just use the walkthrough and avoid all that nonsense. It's right here? Yeah. To my son, Romanos. If you're reading these words, you have found my true hideaway, which means you also have developed a desire to find your own way in life. Know that I'm truly sorry for putting you and your mother through so much. I'm well aware that I'm the world's worst father, leaving you both behind. There's so much about the ways of the world I don't understand, such as why the ghost ship appears and steals people. Where do its victims go? I've decided to dedicate my life to find out the answers. If I fail to return, please take care of your mother, and please forgive me. In closing, one more thing. Embrace your wayfaring ways, my son. Got a treasure map. Don't care. Don't even tell me. To my son, here's the only way to sail through the foggy passage. Well then, let us draw, shall we? You go this way, you do a loop-de-loop, and you go up, and you go down, and you go on. Perfect. Wonder if I could have avoided coming here. It's always on my mind. There's a strange sun emblem on that door, Mangg. I wonder if we can open it. Try touching the door, Mangg. Sure, buddy. That didn't work. It's not opening. But if there's something about this crest that tickles my memory. Hey, why not draw this emblem on your map so we remember it later on? Sure thing. Oh, shit. Hold on. Straight mollywop, you boys. Done. All Alright, let's go. No, god damn it. Astrid. Yeah. I know, it's pretty long video. I'm getting used to just recording for longer periods of time. I don't know if that's really what people want, but it's what I'm doing. What? You actually know how to reach the Northern Sea? The route was written on a map, was it? Please tell me you wrote it on our chart. Did you write it down? Yes. How about we shove off then? Yes. How about you shove off? Okay, so we can do a whole optional section where we get, like, courage gems and maps and money and no one cares, stuff like that. That was a little winding path. I really should make an effort to make it as straight as possible. That's literally the only way I can save time. I guess I'll just redraw it. There we go. Straight as I can. Straight as an arrow. Can't check Facebook ever, because I got stupid things trying to kill me. Uh-huh. Let us draw once again, over here, this way, round and about. I may clip the stone there. I may have fucked that up. I just want to get to the island and then I can stop. That's fine. You know what's odd is I honestly feel like I have a memory of doing this. I don't know if this was in Wind Waker at some point or not. Something like this. I seem to remember like sailing through fog and having to go a specific route. So I don't know. It's kind of weird. I don't remember playing Phantom Hourglass. Turn. Enemy not sighted. I'm hoping there isn't too much of these kind of sailing shenanigans. Dead. Okay, now don't clip the rock. Okay, we're fine. Nice. And there's another optional section where you can go, I guess, to that island to the north. And you can get more optional goodies, if that's what you are interested in life. I'm getting money. Get money, get paid. Apparently you can find like a mermaid, and you get a fishing rod, and you can go fishing. Oh god. I'm glad that's optional. Yeah, it's all about, there's this huge optional fishing section. It's massive. It's massive, man. Alright, good. Made it through that horrible fog, finally. We certainly did. So this is the Isle of Gust, the Temple of the Wind. And then we do the Temple of Courage, Ghost Ship, so on and so forth. I mean, it's a Zelda game. They're not utterly short. Whew, we finally made it to the island. This sure is one gusty isle. Yep, surely this has got to be the Isle of Gust. So, you little green parrot, how about you go fly off in search of our next spirit? Will do. We'll leave off this video here. Hour and 20 minutes, that's not too bad, right? Right? My name is Mangg. Gaming watching has been The Legend of Zelda Phantom Hourglass. It is really great to be able to say that. I mean, when I first started doing, like, Zelda 2 or something, it was just like, god damn, I got so many games ahead of me. But anyways, Phantom Hourglass, I'll see you fine folks in the next part.